That's a giant. That's a giant. Oh my gosh.
How's it going, everybody? I am heading out to Lake Sutherland in Ramona, California today. It's a bit of a drive to get to Lake Sutherland. This is one of the isolated lakes in San Diego, and it's going to take me over an hour to drive there. It is a seasonal lake, so it closes down for, I don't even know how many months, 4 months maybe. Last time I was there was late summer, and we're in mid-March right now. So it's been a long time. I'm a big fan of this lake. I wish it was closer. I would fish it a lot more, but then again, if it was closer, so would everybody else. Good thing about this lake is that it is a reaction baits type of lake, being compared to the other lakes in San Diego. And that is because there is dirtier water, so you can get away with it pretty much throughout the year, and there's just a lot of structure, a lot of wood, trees, especially if the water's up. The last time I fished here, the water was up pretty well. I don't know how it's doing right now, but we have had some rain, so I'm expecting some pretty dirty water and some tough fishing. The weather still just isn't quite there like I would hope it would be. It's still pretty cool, and then for this lake, it takes a little bit longer for the spawn to happen, obviously, because it's up there isolated in the mountains, and it gets cooler during the colder months. But once San Diego starts heating up, Ramona really starts heating up, so it could turn over, you know, like a light switch. I'm almost there. Got another 20 minutes or so I will get off here, make sure I don't crash, and see you guys out on the water.
That was a good one. He broke me off. That should not have happened. Alright guys, I just got broken off, and on a spinnerbait, the fish just came up right over here and tried to throw the spinnerbait so I can see it and get it back to one of my favorite spinner baits, but I don't know what happened to the fishing line. There's no way it should have snapped. I mean, I got lazy and I couldn't net him, but it's not a tournament. So I got him up to the side of the boat, and I'm using 12-pound FC Sniper. I just tried to pull him up and over the boat by the line, and the line snapped, so. I have been fishing it in the sticks today, but I've only been fishing for 20 minutes. This is somewhat new line, so I don't know if it rubbed against the side of my kayak. My kayak's got some scratches in it, so it could have rubbed against the side of the kayak and frayed the line as I was pulling it up, but I'm honestly kind of shocked that that just happened. Alright guys, just had bite number two. didn't land the fish. He came up and pretty close near the boat, swiped at it, was on for a split second, and when I set the hook, the bait flew out of the water. And then after looking at the bait, the trailer was pulled down, and there's a wire keeper there, so the fish couldn't strip it from the hook, but he definitely came up and got the back part of the tail. Missed the hook, unfortunately, but that's a good sign. And I mean, not even 15 casts in, it's already been bit. This thing that makes me a little bit nervous is the fish didn't get the whole bait. For 3 right now. That's the unfortunate part about hooking them in the shallow of water, is keeping them down is hard. missed him. I know, it's killing me.
That's a giant. Oh my gosh. Stay down. Oh, that's a giant.
Measurement on her. Of course, I'm not in a monthly or anything. Twenty-two and a half inch. 514. All right, let's let her go. Goodbye. Go on, get out of here. There she goes.
Alright guys, that's gonna do it. Not a bad day at all. No complaints here. Getting a topwater bite in 57 to 59 degree water is something that I didn't expect, but I'm glad that I brought the frog. I'm glad that I decided to throw it, and you know, I was rewarded. It was a good time. I only ended up catching two frogfish, but you know, snapped that spinnerbait off right out of the gate, which was, it was nice to get bit. That sun came out, I don't know if you guys noticed or not, but that sun was out and it was warm for about a 30 minute period. And during that 30 minute period, I got three bites, and one on the spinnerbait, which, trying to lift that fish in, kind of looking back at the video now, that fish was pulling one way. I tried to pull his head back the other way with the line. The line had to have been frayed. That was 12 pound FC Sniper. So it is what it is. Broke the fish off. You know, it wasn't a giant, so it wasn't that depressing. But it was nice to get bit that soon. I'd only been fishing for a little bit. And then tied on the swim jig. Lost that big one. When I go back and I watch the video, it doesn't look that big, but trust me, that was a big fish. It was not as big as the frog fish, but it was probably around a 20-inch fish, you know, 3.5-4 pounder. And, you know, just kicked my butt, jumped twice, trying to keep it down. I was in the middle of trying to get my net staged, and that's what I get. You know, I should have paid more attention to the fish, but again, a good sign. And before that, I had been bit on the swim jig, as it was, I don't even think I included it in the video, but as I was bringing the swim jig up out of the water, a fish came by and grabbed the end of the tail, and you know, that was three bites in 30 minutes, but none landed. So made it down to the end of the cove where I thought there might be some fish staging, getting ready to spawn. Did not expect the water to be that cold. It was a little bit colder than I thought it was going to be, but I was thinking it would be more around 60 to 62. It was 57 to 59, but it was a place where I wanted to throw top water just to see. Got that little smack in the beginning, and it just, you know, clued me in that, hey, they're willing to come up and investigate. So I really love throwing the frog, like most people do that are bass fishermen, and just kept throwing it and got rewarded. So not a bad day at all. And then ended it with a nice swim jig fish, three fish total and some good bites. Not a bad day at all for San Diego. But I'll go over kind of what I was throwing to show you guys here. I know the lighting in my garage is terrible. I've said this a million times. I apologize. It's just, it is what it is. I got to get better lighting in here. This is the megabass, big gabot. I'll have all this stuff linked down in the description below. But this is a brand new frog, just came out in the bluegill color. Notice that cup on the face is a lot different than any other frog that I've ever seen. Not your typical popping frog, but it walks really easy. I love the color on it. Having that neon yellow on the top is awesome because you can track this frog from a long ways away. Ended up missing that fish. I don't know, it in the video he hit it twice. At least I believe it was the same fish. And I was hooked up to him and he popped free twice. That was a really good fish. That fish, unfortunately, my shoulder is blocking the view of the strike, but that fish came completely out of water. I saw its entire body, and I believe it was bigger than the 22.5 that I caught. It was a monster. It could have been, possibly could have been my new PB. Set the hook, and the fish was on there. I mean, I fought him for a little bit, and then it popped free. I threw back in there the very next cast, and the frog got hit again. This hit you can see, but this was a lot different. It was more of a slurp down than an explosion. So who knows if it was the same fish. I have no idea, but fought that fish for a little bit and then lost him. So ended up bending the hooks up and you know, sticking fish after I did that. Even though I do that to all my frogs, I guess I just bent it up even more. I'll go over the swim jig. This is a swim jig made by Battle Baits. Great company. If you don't know who they are, check them out. This swim jig is awesome. It is a crappie color, and I don't know how well you guys are gonna be able to see that on camera, but it's got like a blue glimmer to it. It's got the white on the bottom, the black and green, you know, specks in the skirt. And then this trailer is a Yum Money minnow I just put on there about 10 minutes ago. What I actually was throwing was the new boot tail Zacos. Kind of like the Zacos or Zacos, however you want to pronounce it, from Yamamoto. It is that same bait, but instead of it being the chatterbait trailer style with the V-tail, it has a boot tail. So it's got a lot more thump than this money minnow does, but I don't really use my money minnows that often, and I kind of want to start either getting rid of them or seeing if they could work as a trailer on the back of that swim jig. So that's it. Hopefully I will be getting out there, you know, pretty soon and fishing Lake Sutherland again. But really appreciate you guys watching my videos, especially if you tune all the way, if you tuned in all the way to the end. I appreciate that. Please like it. Give me a thumbs up. A comment would be awesome, but I really would like you guys to subscribe. That would help me a lot, help me keep making these videos, and I got a lot more to come. I've got like 10 videos waiting, ready to go, and I'll be posting them here soon. So stick with me, and I'll see you guys out on the water soon. Thanks.